Peterson here with Peterson Electric. Fourth part of this video, and I'll have one more once all this stuff looks beautiful and the hot tub's sitting there. Hopefully the Flagstone guys will be done by then. Fifth part of this video is the service change. We did this today. We always pull a permit because these little tags, that's what you're buying right there. You can't get that unless you know a guy who's going to, you know, trade you for beer and shove a bunch in your pocket, but not here in the city of Loveland. Anyways, here's right here, another tag. This is your feet inside of here, okay? We did a service change out. I don't have a screwdriver. I'm not going to open this, but our grounding and our bonding was done. In Loveland, believe it or not, it's only one ground rod. Isn't that awesome? I didn't have to do anything. And all downstairs, this house is only 20 years old, so I already had a cold waterer there as a number 6. I did not go up to 200 amp to put in a number 4. One thing, the power company said, no, we're not going to let you do 200 amps unless you upgrade their transformer and a volt. And the other side of it is that I'd have to redo and damage their basement pretty bad to get a number 4 in. So, and she did look at that, our inspector. But you've got a 30 amp AC, and what we had here before was 100 amp in only 4 spots. Now I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and it also has the teeth on it, is what I would call it, so you can actually put quads in there, and that basically is an 816 service pin. Now this is 100 amp to the house, you'll never get anything more, but I can get a 2050 quad, but not a 60, and I can get a 2030 and a 2020, or a 2040, or whatever, 1520. So I got plenty of space here in the future if they want to expand, which I doubt they will. I got my expansion fitting on here. I've got my strap above the expansion fitting, so this is allowed to slip and sleeve, not here, but up here. This stays stationary. Just went ahead and cheap transitioned this so the conduit could flex in. Put in my intersystem bonding bridge bar. Went ahead and grounded that for these guys. And my 150 amp main with the bypass levers inside, which I can't show you because it's already sealed up. Why did we do that? Because we wanted the extra 50 amps for the hot tub. In case they get an evil car, anything. Cryptocurrency is a big thing nowadays. You might need an extra 50 amps, or if you're going to grow a bunch of weed in Colorado, or luckily some other states are doing it now. But anyway, so here's the service upgrade. We didn't have to do anything other than that. The gas guy from Fire Pit, here's him. He's coming up here to the main, however he's doing that, or when the hell he's doing it, I don't know. But there's your gas guy coming down. Now, for this hot tub run, I probably could have gone down in that pit with him. Timing is essential in these jobs. This was done in January for the underground, and we were pretty damn cold for January, February. Other than that, the rest of the winter was not much. We didn't get a ton of snow here in 2017 to 2018. That's when the video is, by the way. This is April 3rd on 2018. But yeah, we could have got that in possibly. Part of the issue was the underground fed right here. We did not want to get that coming out of here. We probably could have put a 1-inch PVC and curved it. The other problem with curving that is trying to stay within our 270 degree worth of vents underground. I don't really think 360 is a good idea, but 270 to 300 degrees, we might have been able to achieve that. The issue we had was this spot. That was a pretty tight bend, and then there was a bunch of cement blocks right in here, and then this pole. So if we could have put the disconnect here, we could have come up here and then gone that way, but then they would have had to dug out more here, and they didn't really want to do that. So then otherwise our hot tub would have been another tight bend and another tight bend. So we all, and besides that, if the inspector got me that this wasn't within sight because of the gate and the gutter, it's actually in code that the gate's in the way. So I might have flunked that and the whole underground would have been screwed. So I just decided to go overhead, which probably some of you guys are going to be a bunch of pricks and, you know, say something on my YouTube about this, but that was the only way. I did talk to them about taking that gutter off and getting them to stand it off, and we could have made it tighter, but they didn't want to do that. So again, I don't need all your comments on the underground of this. This is kind of where it ended up with the weather and the landscaper and the customer and what they chose to do and what not to do. A lot of it fell into place, and that's the reason why. Anyways, guys, thanks for joining us. Hopefully that'll help you out. And yeah, this is just, you know, a whole entire fire pit, Flagstones, courtyard, pop-up outlets, landscape lighting, underground feed, and then 2-year service upgrade. That's what these videos were about. Thanks.